Hey, Dure, I'm here out in beautiful Athol with my one of my good volunteers here, Jeremy.
How you doing?
And you know, back starting in March, as many of you know, I started sharing my views as a PhD, as a scientist who studies the immune system and personalized medicine, about the complete fraud of Fauci, about this entire coronavirus scam. No one else was courageous enough to call it out, because they don't have a scientific background. In fact, those people who have a scientific background won't say anything because they're part of the establishment. I guess I got lucky because I got all those degrees at MIT, did scientific research, but I never forgot where I came from. So I was the first one to, if you remember, I did that tweet and I said, as an MIT PhD in biological engineering, I said, this fear mongering of the coronavirus will go down in history as one of the biggest scams intended to force mandated medicine, intended to suppress dissent, and then also intended to make sure that that all of us essentially got on board with this, and that we were part of a model to destroy a real economy of everyday working people. And all of those have come true. Now, why was I able to do that? Because I understand the immune system. I understand the fact that the immune system is very strong. All these people here who are going by here, as you can see, we're standing here doing a standout. We are handing out cards here. We do this every day. And by the way, someone just passed by and they said, you know, I turned around my car because I see you actually got volunteers. We have thousands of volunteers all over the state doing this. And I go with others to support them because we're running a real campaign. But what I wanted to talk about is about cooking the books on this coronavirus scam. And Jeremy's going to share a very interesting truth about one of his friends who's in the National Guard and the nonsense that's going back in New York. And I'm sure you guys have heard a lot of this. It's essentially, fundamentally, what's going on is you have the elites, and it's very simple. It's not even conspiracy. You have a set of people who are interested in one thing, making tons of money, profit, power, and control. That's what they're interested in. And everyday American people who are good people, sometimes they're too good, naive, and innocent, there's a lack of appreciation for how evil and how power hungry, how profit hungry, and how control hungry these people are. So this entire thing has been created. You have a bunch of people now, like robots, marching around wearing masks, which do nothing. You can get the N95 masks that may protect you. That's for healthcare workers. And as I've done in one of my videos, I've shown you that the cloth mask, you're going to increase your chance of influenza. And the medical mask, you know, they're about the same, but they do nothing for you because it's like a mosquito going through a chain link fence. The N95 masks you wear too long, they're going to give you headaches. So you have a bunch of idiots doing that. And then you have a bunch of fools who are on talking heads, all talking about the vaccine, vaccine, vaccines. No one is talking about boosting the immune system. No one is talking about vitamin D from the sun. No one is talking about how you build community. You boost the immune system, vitamin A, vitamin C, you know, iodine and zinc. These are very, very common things. Thousands, tens of thousands of papers written on it. The reason they don't want to talk about it is because those small minority of people care about one thing: power, profit, and control. And this entire coronavirus scam was architected in August of 2019 in Rwanda. They held the contact tracing meeting. And contact tracing is going to be a multi-billion dollar business. By the way, Partners in Health got essentially the monopoly on that. And then you have mandated medicine, which is going to make trillions. That's what this is about. Follow the money. Stop being, if you see people wearing these stupid masks, we got to stop complying with this nonsense, because this is an attack on freedom. It's an attack on truth, and it's an attack on health. If you really want to support your health, you got to boost, you got to build community, boost immunity. Come to our barbecue tomorrow. A lot of great people, a lot of music. You'll lower your inflammatory compounds. You'll increase your antimicrobials. By the way, this is a fact, 1988 New England Journal of Medicine. But what you have these very evil people out there doing is they're cooking the book.
I think you said crooking the books, right?
Crooking the books, yeah. And what I mean by cooking the books is they're saying alarming, oh my God, everyone's got COVID-19. Yeah, so what? Your answer should be, so what? Right? The issue should be, so what? Because you got 380 trillion viruses in you. And the people that are dying are the people who are immunocompromised. As they age, you hurt your immune system goes down. And no one's talking about that, how we can beef up our elders, how we can save the immunocompromised. The average age of someone who died in Massachusetts is 82.5. The life expectancy is 80. And you do that everywhere. Andrew Cuomo, his thugs, the Clintons, the Kennedys, who, by the way, all work together, all of them, the Clinton-Kennedy clan. And what they're about is making money, 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 period. Now, as a case in point, I was out here, Jeremy and I are doing our standouts, and Jeremy said, hey, my friend in the National Guard, you might want to come in close, Richard.
Yeah, so one of the tactics they use on people is fear-mongering to submit people into, you know, submitting to their mandates. So what they need to do is they need to create an image of this outbreak killing a lot of people. So in the New York City, in the peak of the coronavirus outbreak, they had to bring in the National Guard to help them, you know, remove dead bodies from buildings because they were quarantining the rest of the population. So when they brought in the National Guard, they brought in different units. In this particular unit that a friend of mine was in, him and a bunch of other groups pulled out about 400 bodies out of New York. And every single one of those was labeled as a COVID-19 death. They pulled a guy out of an alley that had a gunshot wound to the head, and they labeled it as a COVID-19 death. So you tell me, where's the truth in all of this?
And the reality is, you get about $13,000-$15,000 for a COVID diagnosis and another $35,000 for a death. So they're making $50,000. You got to understand, this country has been overtaken by lawyers, lobbyists, aristocrats, politicians, and their Clinton Kennedy clan. And you can go to the Obamas, all of them. These people come into politics with no money, and then they got their lawyers helping them protect their money with tax havens like foundations. And what Jeremy's sharing here is just the God's honest way that they do this. They don't care anymore. They just blatantly lie. They cook the books. They cook the books. So anyone wearing a stupid mask, wake the hell up. You're talking to an MIT PhD in biological engineering. Look, someone has the flu virus, have them stay home, self-quarantine. But everyone wearing masks, everyone riding around bicycles, running. And by the way,
driving in their car, conditioned air with a cabin air filter that I'm sure is better than the mask on your face.
Yeah. So what you have is, and by the way, we see people in Harvard, now it's a place where some of the dumbest, most crooked people go. The most dumbest and crooked people go to Harvard, okay? The educated, filthy, vulnerable elite. Running, wearing masks. Running in 98-degree weather, right, Richard?
Yep.
92-degree weather, wearing masks. Why are you following them? We have to stop complying. We're at a point in American history, if we follow this idiocracy, it's game, set, match, it's over. We're headed towards fascism. We're headed towards fiction, making up stuff, fake science, and we're going to destroy our health. We got to go to truth, freedom, and health. That's what our campaign is about. That's why we have to win in Massachusetts, because Massachusetts is the center of the deep state. Right, Jeremy? I mean, think about it. Jeremy, you live out in Central Mass. What's great about where Jeremy lives is you actually got working people here, not the doofuses over near Cambridge that I got to deal with.
Real people that know how to actually get things done, know how to fix things, know how to solve problems. They don't just pay the money to have somebody else do everything for them.
Yeah, if you look at our bus over there, Jeremy, that bus over there, let me just tell everyone, that bus we and our volunteers put together, okay? Everything on that bus we did, none of these lawyers I'm running against, none of these scumbags can do any of those things. And it's about time that we as Americans start voting in real Americans, like people who support our campaign, people like you. We're at a very, very important point in American history. We got to stop complying with nonsense. We got to stop complying with mandated vaccines. We got to stop complying with idiots telling us to wear masks. It's all fake science. Look, let them question my credentials. Come on, bring it on. But I'm telling you, they're cooking the books. Jeremy's your friend is a National Guards guy, right?
Yep.
National Guardsman who puts his life on the line. He was being sent in, pulled people out, people with gunshot wounds and being labeled COVID-19. Stop complying. Stop being sheep. That's how we do it. You know, if you look at many movements that start taking off, non-compliance, right? You can be nonviolent with it. Just don't comply. Stop complaining.
Waking up to the truth and realizing there's another reality and not the one that they're giving you on the TV.
Not the one they're creating. That's why tomorrow, it's a beautiful day, June 27th, Saturday, we're going to have an awesome barbecue. If you're in Massachusetts, you got to show up. You got to rebuild back your confidence, see other people. We're not wearing these stupid masks. Number two, if you're outside of Massachusetts, tell your friends, June 27th, tomorrow, go on to Eventbrite and sign up. But we got to build community, boost immunity. Enough cooking the books. Thanks, Jeremy. Cut.